Pop quiz. Is kale an annual or a perennial? Well, as it turns out, it's actually a trick question, because in most cases, it's neither. But before I explain, let's back up a bit. You see, at the end of last season, a bunch of our brassicas, like our kale, cabbage, and Brussels sprouts, were still doing really well out in the garden. And since we didn't have a lot of room to store them in the house anyway, we instead decided to just cover them up with a silage tarp to help keep them insulated once the snow fell. Then, throughout the beginning of the winter, until the snow got too deep, we'd just go outside, lift up the tarp, and gather what we needed for dinner that night. And let me tell you, that worked out really well, and I think we'll try it again this year. But it also meant that we didn't do our usual final harvest or fall chop and drop. And so that, combined with the protection of the tarp, meant that some of those plants actually survived the harshness of our Canadian winter. All of the leaves and stems died off, but the roots obviously pulled through, as indicated by all of this new growth this spring. So my first thought was, sweet, free food this year. And my second thought was also sweet, something else to add to our ongoing winter sowing experiment. Because while sowing seeds in winter saves sowing time in spring, just covering last year's plants with a tarp would mean never sowing again. Well, after looking into it a bit, I've discovered that the reality is a bit more complicated, but it's also a bit more interesting. You see, up here in Canada, we treat kale like an annual that needs to be replanted every year. And frankly, the same goes for most of our veggies, because they just aren't hardy enough to survive through the harshness of our winter. But in warmer climates, some of these garden plants are actually perennials that come back every season, because there, the temperatures never drop low enough to actually kill them off. Kind of like our asparagus and strawberries, or our chives and rhubarb, not to mention, of course, our fruit trees. These plants just spring back every spring, and some even have a life cycle that lasts for decades or more. But sometimes, either through luck or preparation, some of those non-hardy plants make it through, as was the case this year for some of our kale and Brussels sprouts. But does this mean that if we're careful, we could just keep these veggies alive indefinitely so that their root systems could grow stronger and stronger each year, producing more and more food for decades to come? Unfortunately, no. Because even in warmer climates, most kale varieties, and Brussels sprouts for that matter, aren't actually perennials either. They're biennials, meaning they have a life cycle that spans 2 years, but only 2 years. During the first year, the plant spends most of its energy on roots and foliage. And so from our perspective as gardeners who see it mostly as an edible vegetable, that's by far its most productive time. But of course, kale as a life form doesn't just exist for our dinner table. It also exists to reproduce. And so that's what it spends its energy on during the second year, when its main focus is on producing flowers and seed pods. And just like lettuce and spinach, once it begins to bolt, its leaves become less tender and sweet. They're still edible, but would likely be better off cooked in a soup rather than raw in a salad. So while our main focus will remain on our new first-year plants, we'll also leave a few of these second-year plants in place this year, both to witness their full life cycle and also to see how they taste. Plus, maybe we'll finally try collecting some seeds for next year, something that's been long on our to-do list anyway. So if you're interested, please stay tuned for that. But in the meantime, thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.